Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Heavenly Asia Pacific Chonbu Branch online education program. The title of our topic today is Mind and Body Unity. This is part 8, and this is entitled How to Unite Mind and Body. So how do we unite mind and body? All of us wants to unite our mind and body, isn't it? So because of the fall of man, the body became very strong and controls the conscience. So the body stands as a strong positive, but it is a false positive. And the mind stands as another positive who will never give up that position of positive because it is God's original design for the mind or the conscience. And they fight each other. This kind of fighting and war within ourselves is projected to the society, to the nation, and to the world. And that this individual level fighting between mind and body results in the problems of immorality, corruption, robbery, rape, violence, war, drug abuse, alcohol abuse, smoking, gambling, homosexuality, premarital sex. A personality of true love is not present in that kind of a person. We become a selfish person, a person who only thinks of my own happiness, of my own advantage, of my own self-like gratification. So this person cannot and can never be called a child of God. But if we really want to unite our mind and body and end this kind of problem, then we have to do like two steps. Number one, push the body down by denying the bodily desire. And number two, strengthen the immature mind. So how do we push down the bodily desire, the body? How do we deny the bodily desire? How do we do this? So that's why we are advised to do the bowing condition, like 40 bows, 100 bows, even 1,000 bows. I myself experienced doing that. It's so difficult. The body will complain, but it is really, really good. You feel very good after that. No? Prayer condition. So which one do you like? 1 minute prayer or 1 hour prayer? You need, the body really resists. The body complains once you do things like that. Then waking up early in the morning, like 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock to do prayer. Then do hard work for somebody, for others. Then do the martial arts training, like no pain, no gain, right? So you can also do fasting, vigil, or meditation, self-control, sexual purity. All of these activities can push down the bodily desire. And by doing so, our body can be pushed in the position of object position or the negative, which is the original position of the body. And the mind, how do we strengthen the immature mind? We can do hundukhe, or studying God's words every day, putting God as the priority in our lives, loving God above all, joining the HTM mobilization, attend Divine Principle seminars, attend family services, and then do home group meetings and mobilization, loving your enemy. These are just examples of things we can do to strengthen the immature mind. Once our mind becomes strong because God is dwelling in our mind, then it has enough power to control the body, and that mind and body can unite together, centered on God. So once our mind and body are united together, centered on God, then we prioritize seeking for truth, beauty, goodness, and love. And then we naturally live for the sake of others. Such a person has a well-balanced and harmonious personality. Such a person is called the child of God, sons and daughters of God. This is what we will become. And then God will win. God will dwell in us. And our body becomes, God's body becomes holy body. And we become a person whose mind and body is united together as a child of God, and project this to build a good family, a good society, a good nation, and a good world. And this world will be a peaceful world forever and ever. Lasting world peace can be realized, starting with me as a person of peace, as a person at peace, which is God's original design for man. Thank you very much for listening, brothers and sisters. Please listen to our next topic, which is entitled God's Original Design, a Matter of Priorities. Thank you very much.